Amen. That's how we go out. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, so be it, says the Lord, that this is the day that He made. And I'm glad when I woke up this morning and I realized that there is a place that I can go called church. Amen. And I'm happy to be in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. With that, I'll hand it over to the
church. Please stand for the reading of God's word. And this morning I will be reading for you from Ephesians 4th chapter, verses 1 through 6. And it reads, I therefore, prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that ye walk worthy of the vocation wherewith ye are called, with all lowliness and meekness, with long-suffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as ye are all called in one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all, in you all. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers and doers of His holy word.
May we bow our heads in a word of prayer. Oh, gracious Father, we come this time to just say thank you, Father. We woke up this morning with our minds on you, Father, and we thank you for it. We know there's those here that could not make it, but let on the way, but Lord, continue to bless them while they come. Lord, look on this nation, Father. Lord, look on the president. Lord, yes. As your 100 words, Psalm says that we are your people.
Yes.
We ask you, Lord, to let him open up his mind and realize that we are all your people.
Yes.
Lord, we ask you looking for the sick and the shut-in.
Yes.
Those who are out in the cold without walking over the head.
Yes.
We thank you that we are here with a roof over the head. Here to praise your name.
Yes.
Lord, we ask you, Lord, to open your doors and open the hearts of those that do not know you, Lord.
Yes.
That they may know your name.
Yes.
Continue to bless them, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, look on the word that's coming on today by the pastor. That is the word on God.
Yes.
Take it out of himself and bring you forward.
Yes.
These things I pray, Father, in your name, your Son Jesus' name, that he is the Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Please join me now as we welcome in the people of Christ, the dope choir. Amen.
Thank you.
would say is, we believe that God has given us authority over drama, nonsense, and some of the stuff we see going on. And I think this, I think what we have to do is beseech the Lord and to take authority. He said we would have authority over serpents, over devils. And so it's time for us to take authority right now. Ah, yes, Lord. Can you call his name Jesus?
Jesus.
Ah, yes, Lord. We come to you right now to say thank you. Ah, thank you for everything. Lord, we see calamity everywhere, but we know that you are still on the throne. We know that we see the devil coming over the rise, but you know you will lift up a standard. A standard to quell it right now, Lord. We ask that you keep your arms of protection around this church, this leader, his wife, these great deacons, these great ministers, this great church, Lord. We ask that you protect right now. Protect us right now, Lord, because we see all this stuff going on. We see it all going on, Lord. We know the devil's devices. We know it now. And right now we're asking that you give us the authority in our homes, in our jobs. Ah, yes, Lord. We say yes, Lord. We say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We'll follow you right now, Lord. We'll follow you wherever you send us. We'll follow you right now. Lord, we say thank you for everything. Lord, we can't say thank you enough. We ask that you take the purpose of this service for your glory and your glory alone. And we will always stand. We will say amen. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Lord. And with that, we will have the reading of 100 Psalms by our youth representative this morning, Mr. I.J. Wilkerson. Amen. We'll get I.J. a microphone. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
All ye live.
All ye lands.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Come before his presence with singing.
Come before his presence with singing.
Know ye that the Lord, he is God.
Know ye that the Lord, he is God.
It is he that hath made us.
It is he that hath made us.
And not we ourselves.
And not we ourselves.
We are his people.
We are his people.
And the sheep of his pasture.
And the sheep of his pasture.
Enter into his gates with thanksgiving.
Enter into his gates with thanksgiving.
And into his courts with praise.
And into his courts with praise.
Be thankful unto him.
Be thankful unto him.
And bless his name.
And bless his name.
For the Lord is good.
For the Lord is good.
His mercy is everlasting.
And his truth endureth.
To all generations.
To all generations. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
good to us by giving us tomorrow through our youth. Yeah. Letting us know that POC is going to be in good hands. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, I would like to invite up Isabella. She is going to give us this special announcement.
Amen.
Amen. In the name of the Lord. Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
First, next week's Sunday school lesson called I Am Wonderfully Made, Every Life Counts, Including Mine, on January 21st. Read Psalms 139, 1 through 6, and 13 through 18, then meditate on God's Word. Come to Sunday school and share how He speaks to you. POC brochures. The community outreach will be updating all the POC brochures for the various activities for 2018. Please review any changes that might need to be made in your brochure. Currently, we have brochures for music, WMU, youth, brotherhood, ushers, health and wellness, and mass communication. For further information, please contact Deacon Michael Boyd. POC Women's Choir. Ladies of POC, do you have a desire to celebrate God, giving Him all glory, honor, and praise and worship? We are forming a women's choir, and we welcome you to join. The Women's Choir will sing on 5th Sundays, which is Mission Sunday, and on the WMU Annual Women's Day, which is in April. The first practice will be January 2018. If you're interested, please complete the sign-up sheet in the vestibule. Thank you, Sister Alicia Abel and Sister Margaret Boyd. See, the Children's Evangelism Fellowship. The Child Evangelism Training, all POC members and leadership, ministers, deacons, auxiliary, heads, and teachers are strongly encouraged to attend February 24th, 2018 at 10, to be held at the People of Christ, 11473 West Larch Road, Tracy. This is an opportunity to train, equip, and encourage us as we work to provide a biblical foundation for youth in our church and community. Without a foundational relationship with God, we are not completely equipped to face what life has to tell us.
Amen.
And the theme of 2018 is Faith Forward in Action.
Amen.
You are a first-time visitor. You haven't been here before. You would be so kind as to stand and introduce yourselves. I do have a couple of cards, and we have one distinguished guest who's already sitting by himself. So, is there anyone? I have one other card too from Brother Constant. If you don't mind, please remain standing. Thank you. Amen. Welcome. Yes. Introduce yourself to the family.
My name is Elder Michael Stevens. I'm from Oakland, California, Dancing Morning Church of God in Christ.
We're glad to have you in here today. Please can you stand? I'd like to introduce yourself.
My name is John Constant. I'm from Tracy.
Amen.
Amen. Before you sit down, I just want to say, I've heard to POC more than once as family. This is a Bible teaching, Jesus loving church. Amen. We're more than welcome to come back on behalf of our senior pastor, Eric Garrett, and our pastor, Ernest Willie Rowland, the staff, the deacons, the ushers, the choir. We all love you already. You're more than welcome to come back at any time. And we have a beautiful song that our choir would like to sing, let you know how much we appreciate you.
Welcome.
verses 6 through 8. And it reads, "But this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth abundantly shall reap also abundantly. Every man according as he has purposed in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that ye always, having all sufferings, sufficiency in all things, may abound to every good work. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of the doors of his holy word. Come up, ushers.
But anyway, good morning. I just really
wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you for all of your support throughout this year, and actually throughout all the years. Without the family POC, I don't know how we would be able to do all of the marvelous and wonderful things that we are able to do for the children and with the children. And I really wanted to say, the other thing I really wanted to say is that during the Christmas play, I was just so excited and flustered about how good the play went. We never acknowledged the children. I never called their names. I never did any of that. So I want to say to all of the children that were in the play, that put up with me and all of the other youth committee and all of the adults and mamas telling y'all what to do, to please stand up. All of you that were in the play, Diana, Joshua, Joshua was never in a play. Joshua, on his own, raise your hand, decided he was going to be the lead in the play. And I'm going to tell you, that brother did a great job. The other person I want to say is I didn't thank Joshua Berdios. And he was amazing. He's outgrown acting, but he's doing the prop thing, you know. He got a driver's license now, so we ain't gonna be able to get him. And then Zion, if you can stand up. Zion is also outgrown today, but he's an artist. And then, so I'm gonna say Tiffany, Tiara, Ajay. Who else? Brenea. You know I'm old. Karma, Megan, Joshua, Jordan, Angelo, Annalise, Isabella, Tyra, and Vicky. Is that everybody?
No.
Who else? Who did I miss? Oh, Braylon. Can't miss my grandchild, Braylon. That's everybody. If I didn't call your name, please stand up. Oh, Brother Mike, I didn't give you a shout out. I don't know where he is. He's back there. And where is he? Oh, he's back there. And then, who else? Isaac for helping out.
Amen.
Destiny. Nevaeh. Oh, Diana, our dancer.
Amen.
And I think that's it. Oh, and Cosine. Cosine always comes through in the, you know, in the pitch. Yeah. And I think I have everybody. All right. Okay, so the other thing I want to do before we start with our program is please turn to if you haven't had your newsletter. In the newsletter, we are acknowledging some pretty awesome kids. And I know that Rogers is not here, but Rogers received a four-year football scholarship to Arkansas Baptist College. And then Tyler, are you here?
No.
Stand up. Man. Tyler's the tallest thing in here. Poor child. Congratulations on getting all tournament team for a holiday classic tournament. Isabella Turner, stand up. Isabella came in first place on four and third place in gymnastics. And then finally, Cutie Patootie Karma, stand up. Congratulations on your phenomenal score on the Student Diagnostic Report Enterprise Test. And it adds, your test performance is better than that of any average fifth grader.
First, giving honor to God, to our pastor, Pastor Meredith Rowland,
all of the reverends and ministers, family and friends in the house of God today. Welcome to Youth Sunday. Amen?
Amen.
So we're really excited. We have a special program today. But what I wanted to pick up from Sister Knight is karma. Karma, stand up again, because she told you that she scored better than any average fifth grader. This child is 7 years old in the second grade. Amen? That's amazing. And what I always like to say is that our children are representing the Spirit of God outside the walls of this church.
Yes.
That's what we pray for. That's why we support them. And that's why we come together as a congregation to make sure that they're all doing great outside of the walls of this church. As long as in here, right?
Amen.
Amen. Because they represent POC also. So, if you have a birthday and you're a youth, if you have a birthday in the month of January, please stand. No January birthdays? One January birthday. Happy birthday, Megan. This is Megan Beard. Megan, is this your 12th or 13th birthday? 12th birthday. Okay. No, Sister Walls, who is no longer with us, she's away getting her doctorate degree, did the birthdays for us, amen. But what I always like to, at the very minimum, we have cupcakes out in the vestibule. We like to acknowledge our youth, amen.
Amen.
Happy birthday, Megan. One of the other things that we will do today is all of our youth will get a bracelet. You can pick one that says WWJD, What Would Jesus Do? Or their little rubber bracelets, and this one in particular, they're different colors. This one has purity. I love these little bracelets. I wear them myself, different style, but I wear them myself, and it keeps as a reminder for all of us. We can just look down on our wrists and see those traits that God expects us to portray. Amen?
Amen.
Now, the youth department is also in control of the children's church. And so I've been saying that we need more teachers in children's church. In year 2017, God has called three of our teachers to just take different journeys, amen? And so we no longer have the three. That would be Sister Walls, which we celebrated greatly as a congregation. She went on, like I said, to get her doctorate's degree. Sister Williams, who taught fourth Sundays, and Sister Croom, who's here, she taught third Sunday. So Sister Williams is not with us, but we will be doing the same acknowledgement for Sister Williams that we did for Sister Croom's. Tyra, can you bring forth? Just to thank her for her years of service, and Sister Croom's, if you can come forward, please.
Amen.
One Sunday out of the month, and Sister Cruz taught third Sunday. How many years, Sister Cruz? Three or four? Yes. So when the children and I, we were together for the last several weeks, she taught maybe 3 or 4 years with us, but we know over 3 years, dedicated teacher. And so they have a card for her. And so one of the things that kept me behind this morning was my printer all of a sudden ran out of ink. So we didn't have a special card that the children made for Sister Croom's. But they each came up with a word for thank you. And if I recall, the T was just thank you, H is helpful, A was awesome, and she'll get her card. But N was nice, K was she has knowledge about the Word of God and she's so kind. When the children came up for the Y, they just said, you are awesome, you are wonderful. O was outstanding, and of course we will miss you. And U was just another list of the things that they think about her, amen, and she will get her card. But one of the things that came up often about Sister Crooms was just how nice she was. With Sister Crooms and Sister Williams, you just kept hearing the children say how well they talked of the Word of God. Amen? And that was just so wonderful to hear from the children. And they said even when it was a good lesson, the teachers would sometimes revisit those lessons that were really good to make sure that they really received the Word of God. So that's what our children are doing upstairs when we send them out after all. Okay, so the other thing that the children have is a song that they would like to do, so we have our youth choir coming forward. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you.
children are really committed to God. I just want to reinforce that we thank all of our volunteers for the youth department. Sister Williams will be receiving the same gift that Sister Crooms has received. And know that the children came up with the gift that their children will receive. Amen?
Amen.
And so we just, that concludes our youth department.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't think at the time
King knew just how much his words would mean to us today. But I'm sure that Dr. King knew that with God all things are possible. Again, that comes from him having that relationship with Jesus Almighty. Now today and tomorrow, people are honoring Dr. King in their own special way, but do you know that there are some parts of the country where people are still working to circumvent the right for others to vote? This ain't 1965, people. In 1965, Dr. King, I'm talking about, walked through Selma, Alabama with the threat of physical violence just so people could vote. He didn't do it with the National Guard. He did it with the church. He did it with the brothers and sisters of the congregation, ministers, deacons, ushers, people in the choir. And you know what he had on? He had on the full armor of God. See, we all know that Dr. King's non-violent position was the one that bothered people the most. But I knew somebody that came 2,000 years ago that had the same non-violent position that taught us all the way to go. You gotta have a personal relationship with Jesus. And today I'm not here to talk about national politics, I'm not here to talk about a politician. I'm here to talk about a man who had a personal relationship with Christ. It just so happens he's one of the most famous people in my generation. Amen. We're talking about Dr. King.
Amen.
50 years ago, since he was taken away. Now, we should be mindful too. I talked a little bit about 1955 and 1965, but in 1968, it took a man of courage to go to Memphis, Tennessee to speak. Even though people were threatening his life, the man of courage still stood and talked about what was right. Right now we're talking about people being superior to one another. We're talking about people being better than one another. All King talked about was equality. All he talked about was children from all backgrounds, holding hands, playing. He didn't hurt anybody. But on April the 3rd, he did have the courage to go, as I said once again, to stand at the Mason Temple and talk about the prosperity that was being denied simply because people looked like me. And on that night, Dr. King said a few words, and these are his words that I want to share with you. Some of these words are probably iconic, already in your mind. I'll remind you that on that night he said, "Well, I don't know what will happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter to me now, because I've been to the mountaintop. And I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live long. A long life. Longevity has its place. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that as a people, we will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. Those words spoken by Dr. Martin Luther King on April 3rd, 1968, in what would be his last public address. Words to live by, words we cling to, words that are etched forever in the history of this country. Never mind what's going on in Washington, D.C. They can't erase that. We will see the promised land as long as we have a relationship with the promised land. Amen. Forgiveness, this is not a sermon, this is just a word about Dr. King. But I want to finish with one thing, and that is, I can only imagine what Dr. King would have said once he made it to that throne of grace, and he was bowed down at the feet of Jesus, looking up to him. I'm sure Dr. King would have said something like, "Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, I'm free at last." Thank you.
this?
This is the day that the Lord has made.
And
I will rejoice and be glad in it.
And I will let
nothing be known.
Amen.
Amen.
I thank God for His goodness.
Yes.
And I'm appreciative of the presence of each and every one of you this morning.
Yes, Lord.
We have a very special announcement. If you have a little time, Dr. Stiles, come over.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord.
Thank you, Pastor, for giving honor to God, who is truly the head of my life, to our pastor, senior pastor, to our pastor emeritus, to all of you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. As you heard Reverend Cooper state, this weekend we are celebrating Martin Luther King Jr.'s birthday. And on tomorrow, we will be hosting at West High School the Martin Luther King Jr. Breakfast. And as many of you know, I am president, this is my second year, as president of Tracy African American Association. I'm blessed to have a number of my board members to be from POC, and I'm going to ask our education chair, Patricia Jackson, to join me here, please.
Amen.
And I want you to know ahead of time that on tomorrow morning at the 8:30 breakfast, we will award the Martin Luther King Jr. Image Award to our own Yolanda Burial Knight.
Joshua, Joshua. Amen?
Amen.
And that's amen.
Amen.
We go to the first chapter. Let's read verses 1 through 9. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know it's our custom. We're going to watch our commas. Amen. Amen. We're going to watch them semicolons.
Amen.
Amen. Colons. Periods. Oh, hey, come on now. We need to read in unison. Amen. All right. All right. Joshua, the first chapter, verse 1 through 9, King James Version. It says what? Now.
Peace
in the midst of my own confusion. Lord, we say thank you, Lord, for a reasonable portion of health and strength. Lord, I thank you that your power and your presence, you said you would never leave us. You said you would never forsake us. We thank you, Lord, for last night's laying down. Lord, I didn't need any cognac. I didn't need any wine. I didn't have to smoke. I didn't have to take no one else's medication. I didn't need to drop no pill. All I did was lay down. Comfort in your arms. Thank you, Master. Still got a roof over my head. Floor underneath my feet. Thank you, Lord. Clothes on my back. But Lord, I praise God. You clothed me in my right mind. Come give you a little more praise. To come worship you in spirit and in truth. Lord, we pray for those in the hospital right now. Praying for those behind prison bars now, Lord. Praying for those that may be homeless, don't have a home to call their own. Praying for those that may be hungry, that don't have food to eat. Holy Spirit, will you move? You are our comforter. You are our guide. You are our counselor. You are our encourager. Touch right now. Thank you. You're omnipresent. You're omniscient. You know all about it, Holy Ghost. Touch it right now. Speak like only you can. Tell them everything. It's going to be all right. We believe it. We trust in you, Lord. You can do everything but fail. Pray over these, your people, Lord. You know, Lord. Somebody had to press their way here this morning. Hellhounds on their tail. Devil didn't want them to come, but they pressed their way here. Touch right now, Lord, every house represented here, Lord. Lord, you give them what they're in need of. Lord, you said you supply all of our needs, but you're so good. You bless us with some wants. Now it's me. It's me. It's me, oh Lord. Standing in the need of prayer. And may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Oh Lord, you are my strength. And you are my redeemer. As I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank God. We've been practicing. Amen. Amen. The dream continues. You know, everybody's a critic. You didn't do it right. Thank you, Brother Archie. Amen. The dream continues. There was a poet, an African-American poet by the name of Langston Hughes. Just to share, you know, we don't talk enough about our black heroes, our sheroes. Amen. So here, a black African-American poet by the name of Langston Hughes, and he wrote, "What happened to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun? Or fester like a sore and then run? Does it stink like rotten meat? Or does it crust and sugar over like syrupy sweet? Or maybe it just sags like a heavy load? Or does it explode?" Today we celebrate the life and the legacy of an African-American male. We know him as Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. He's affectionately known as the Dreamer. Many people, both black and white, looked upon Dr. King as the modern day Moses. Mm-hmm. As we embrace his views of nonviolence as a correct way to bring about equality to people for 400 years have been oppressed and disenfranchised. But the question today, now that the dreamer is gone, what has happened to the dream? We gather here in January to celebrate, not only to celebrate his life and his contributions, but we come together to diagnose and prognose of the dream. I ask you, what has happened to the dream? It was a certain time, a certain place, surrounded by a certain set of events and situations that a certain person, who a certain name just happened to be Martin Luther King Jr., he was lifted up by the sovereignty of God, the wings of destiny, and catapulted him to an unheard of level that is seldom achieved by any mortal man. Mm-hmm. I submit that Dr. King was a role model.
Amen.
He was a role model. And many of you, you pursue life professions, vocation that deals with having someone you have to follow, a great man or a great woman. Some of you are educators, engineers, administrators, some of you are lawyers, doctors, judges, some of you are entertainers, entrepreneurs, amen. And some of you, you're going to have to follow someone whose work's life is marked only by excellence and can only be described in superlative. Well, that scenario is just about what happened to Joshua. He had to follow a great one. How would you like to have been Joshua? And the record records and reports that he succeeded this great one, being Moses. And the Bible only records three things about him. It's in verse 1. It says, now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, only three things was recorded about Joshua. He was the son of Nun, he was a servant of Moses, and I'm just throwing the other one, he was 80 years old. God called an ordinary man.
Well,
Joshua was not the mighty man that Moses was. Joshua, he wasn't raised in Pharaoh's palace. He was not raised in the palace. And Joshua, he did not go to the University of Egypt like Moses did. Joshua, he did not stretch his rod, and heaven did not come down like a hydraulic system and pull back the waters of the Red Sea. He did not watch the Israel, they walked over dry land. He was not a mighty man that Moses was. He didn't have a rod that he came before the Egyptian magicians, and his rod turned to a serpent and swallowed up their serpents. Joshua, he never prayed and watched God rain down manna for heaven for 40 years. Joshua, he never hit a rock, and the thirst of 2 million people was quenched from the water that came from that rock. Joshua, he never went up to the mountain and had an encounter with God, and he came down with a Shekinah glory over his face. Joshua, he was not the mighty man that Moses was. He was an ordinary man. But what he did have more than compensated for what he did not have. He didn't have the gift of Moses, but he knew the God. It says in verse 2, says, look at this. Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise. I just want to park right there. Nora, as we watching our punctuation, it said, Moses, my servant is dead. Semicolon. Yeah. Now, therefore, rise. It's really interesting because there is no now after death. See, when we look at death and we look at the dead, it represents final. Death speaks of the conclusion. Death brings the end of things. Death means no more. Death means the closure of a situation. But look at the text. There is no period there. There is a semicolon. Why the semicolon is there? Because God is not the God of death. Death is not final with God. God is the God of a semicolon. Y'all with me? I got the word with me. There is no period there. And when you have a, many of your educators already know, when you have a semicolon there, what precedes the semicolon and what's after the semicolon carries the same weight. Moses, my servant, is dead, semicolon, now. God is a God. He's of a semicolon. He is a God of eternal semicolon. Okay, some of you, I lost some of you. That's okay. I spent time in the portables too. Okay? 15 over. Okay. And if you didn't get the semicolon, okay, let's put a conjunction and a noun in there. Okay, the conjunction would be like this. My servant Moses is dead.
There was 430 years they spent in Egypt.
And then at the end of that 430 years, that's when God called the emancipator by the name of Moses. Dream did not belong to Dr. King, and it did not belong to Moses. The dream does not belong to us. Can I just have somebody, the dream belongs to God. We're only stewards of the dream. The dream belongs to God. It was God's idea that all men would be created equal and free to pursue life, liberty, and happiness. The dream did not belong to Dr. King. It did not belong to Moses. It did not belong to Abraham. It belonged to God. And I'm glad. I'm so glad that the dream did not belong to Dr. King. Because if the dream had belonged to Dr. King, those vicious dogs in the South would have chewed up and ate the dream. I'm so glad that the dream did not belong to Dr. King. Because if the dream had belonged to Dr. King, there was a racist by the name of Lester Maddox. He put water holes on our people. It would have washed out and drowned the dream. I am so glad that the dream did not belong to Dr. King, because if the dream had belonged to Dr. King in Birmingham, they would have bombed and blew up the dream. I am so glad that the dream did not belong to Dr. King, because if the dream had belonged to Dr. King in Mississippi, they would have lynched and they would have burned the dream. I am so glad that the dream did not belong to Dr. King. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of their life. Look at the promise of the dream. As I was with Moses, I will be with you. That's the promise. He said, I will not fail thee nor forsake. Be strong and of good courage. Under this people shall thou divide inheritance and land. The promise of the dream. God promised his presence and his power. His presence and power. And I wanted to encourage you in 2018. Don't get discouraged. Don't throw in the towel. God said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. When you get in trouble, just call out his name. He is a God that will show up, and he's going to show out. Just like at the Red Sea, he showed up, and he showed out. Just like at that Jordan, he showed up, and he showed out. I wish I could get a witness in here this morning that God never showed up in your life and showed out. He promised, I'll never leave you. I'm going to go ahead and be alone.
Yeah.
All right, buddy. As I was talking with my son last night, I didn't even mention Langston Hughes. I said, son, do you remember a guy by the name of Bobby Fischer? Is it not? So you didn't remember? I said, Google it. Google it, Google it, Google it. Bobby Fischer was a chess master. And there's a story, this illustration that went that when Bobby Fischer was on vacation, he went to Europe and he engaged in one of his favorite hobbies. It was visiting museums. And there's this one particular museum that Bobby Fischer found interesting. Amen. It was a portrait, an intriguing portrait. The portrait was so mesmerizing, amen, that it's recorded that Bobby Fischer stood there for 6 hours studying and examining this portrait. He stayed there for 6 hours. He was intrigued. So Bobby Fischer, being a chess master, he thought, yes, you're right, the portrait was of a chess game. He sat there. He watched. And one of the opponents was Satan. Satan there grinning, cheesing. And he's got his arm out ready to make a move. The other opponent was a young man. The young man was terrified, trembling, and tears running down his eyes. And he's biting his nails. The young man was terrified, and Satan was ready. But as Bobby Fischer, he studied the portrait, and then it came, he looked at the bottom of the portrait, and it said, checkmate. It said, checkmate. 6 hours, Bobby Fischer studied this portrait, studied this game, and what he did, he called one of his partners. He said, go get my chess board. And they brought his chessboard, and Bobby Fischer, he set up his pieces just like the one in the portrait. And he looked, and he studied, and he began to smile. And he said, I wish the young man could hear me. Satan thinks there's only one left. He said, I wish the young man could hear me, that I could encourage him to let him know there's another move. Do you not know that God and Satan have been involved in a chess game? It was God, it was a move, then a counter move. God made a move and he made man. Then Satan counter moved and brought sin into the world. God made a move and he took a sinless lamb, unblemished lamb. He slew the lamb and covered man with the blood. But then Satan made a counter move. Amen. And he had Cain to kill Abel. Amen. And then God, he made another move. And he called Abraham. And because of Abraham's obedience, he said, you will rise up a nation. But then Satan, he made a counter move. And the people was led to idolatry and led into Egypt for 430 years. But then God made another move. And he called Moses and told Moses, go tell Pharaoh and let my people go. But then Satan made a counter move. Amen. In the wilderness, they disobeyed God and they was rebellious to God. But then God made another move. And he brought in kings to rule the land. But then Satan made another counter move, and he said that every man did what was right in their own eyes. And this went on and went on, and then it stepped into the New Testament. And God made another move, that he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that he forever believed in him, should not perish, but have everlasting life. But then Satan made a counter move, and then hung him on the cross. He hung, shed precious blood, and he died and straight. encourage you. 2018, don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. God's got your back. He's got your front. He's all around. I'm so glad. Angels keep watching over me. All day and all night. The door to church is open. Stand, please.
God's presence. Stop and thank Pastor Garrett and our beautiful First Lady, Sister Garrett, on your way out for enlightening us on the promise that was made many, many years ago by Jesus Christ himself. Amen. Amen. Let us please stand as I give you some final words from a beautiful benediction that I hope will find you and keep you until we meet again. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us.